stunningly beautiful evening in the city by the bay. Tonight, the Giants and the Dodgers go at it at Pacific Bell Park. Hello, everyone. I'm John Miller, along with Mike Kruko. Welcome to San Francisco Giants baseball. The Giants and Dodgers going at it. They're tied for second in the West. But the Giants right now, they're just trying to stay alive. Every day, some other outfielder seems to go down. All three of their regular starting outfielders have gone down, with Shinjo going into the disabled list yesterday. And now even one of the backup outfielders has gone down.
Well, Dusty Baker got to the ballpark today, and he penciled in Sean Dunston to be in the outfield tonight as a starter. But guess what? He's got a sore hamstring. So Ramon Martinez finds his body back in left field. But the big thing tonight is going to be Torcato. Tony Torcato will be making his Major League debut in right field. Last week, he was the PCL Player of the Week, the 1998 first-round draft pick. Is amped, and the Giants hope that he can light a fuse for him.
All right, so Torcato makes his Major League debut against Nomo. Ortiz for the Giants, permitted to play ball. Stay tuned, we'll be right back to get it started. Beautiful night at Pacific Bell Park. The big crowd is gathering. The Giants and the Dodgers getting ready to play ball. Dodgers' first visit here since the Giants' first homestand of the year. The Giants are involved in two divisional races. The National League West, where they are tied with L.A. for second, four games back of Arizona. And the National League Wild Card race, where the Giants and Dodgers are tied for first, four games ahead of both the Mets and Cincinnati. The Mets defeated the Reds tonight. So that reflects the current status. The winner of this game will gain a half game on those two teams. So the Giants are in a race with not just Arizona, the team they'd really like to supplant at the top, but also the Dodgers. And, of course, at the moment, the Mets and the Reds. Let's take a look at the Dodgers batting order now, brought to you by the California Lottery. It'll be Dave Roberts leading it off in center field, then Paulo Duque, the catcher, Sean Green, who has been great on the road this year. He's in right field. Brian Jordan, the former Brave, in left field. Tyler Houston, his first game as a Dodger, just acquired from the Milwaukee Brewers. Adrian Beltre will be at third base. Mark Grzelanik at second. Cesar Isturiz is at shortstop, and Hideo Nomo is the pitcher batting ninth.
On the hill tonight for the Giants will be the right-handed Russ Ortiz, making his 22nd start of the year. Russ, 28 years old. He is 6'1", weighs 210 pounds, 82 strikeouts against 60 walks. And really, it's sort of been a tale of two halves for Russ Ortiz. For a lot of the first half, he did not have the command of his fastball. The fastball, a cut fastball, that will average around 90 miles per hour. A cut that will run flat into a left-handed hitter away from a righty. He's got an over-the-top curveball and a changeup, and he was inconsistent with hit stuff. The last four starts, however, the second half, he has been outstanding. He has been dominant, and that's what the Giants hope to see out of him tonight. And defensively behind Russ Ortiz, Dusty Baker has penciled in Martinez. That's right, Ramon Martinez making his first start in the big leagues in left field. Goodwin, Torcato will be in the outfield. Tony Torcato making his Major League debut. Bell, Aurelia Kent, and Minor across the infield, with Jordi Torrealba doing the catching. Let's take a look at our Nissan keys to the game. Set it up for the Rook. Hey, he's the PCL Player of the Week. He's red hot. Get some guys on for him. And for Ortiz, control Grzelanik. He has given him some problems in his career, hitting .417. And you know what? Hey, find a way. You got a lot of guys injured. They don't care. Nobody wants to hear about the labor pains. They just want to see the baby.
And that is too low for ball one to Dave Roberts. Roberts followed by Loduca and then Sean Green. Roberts, 293. He's been starting against all the right-handed pitchers. Now the drag bunt up the first base side. Minor. And he tags him out. Not this time for Dave Roberts.
There for a minute that Damon Minor was going to tackle him on the first baseline. That's about a foot to the advantage of Damon Minor. A good idea. Just got it too close to the line, which allowed the first baseman a chance to come back and make the play. Dave Roberts has become a factor for the Dodgers.
Roberts, before every home game, works with Maury Wills on his bunting, on his base stealing, on the theories behind being a good leadoff man. But not this time for Dave Roberts. The batter is Paul Loduca. Loduca is hitting .303. And he takes a called strike from Russ Ortiz. Now, the Dodgers, we showed you that Sean Green has had a lot more RBIs on the road than he's had at home. The Dodgers as a team have hit a lot better when they've been away from Dodger Stadium. They have a 273 average as a team on the road, only 246 at home. And that goes for Loduca. This should be extra bases. Torcato has to dig it out. I mean, he starts out in his first big league game in one of the most difficult right field areas for playing caroms off many different surfaces in the entire league.
Well, indeed, this is what made Loduca, well, gained his reputation in the National League, his ability to go the other way. And you're right, John, Torcato's going to come over, and his education is going to be like this, with balls hit to him. You can't tell a guy about the type of banks and caroms he's likely to get in right field here. He has to see it for himself.
First place Arizona, by the way, is in action in Phoenix against the San Diego Padres with Randy Johnson on the mound. And the Diamondbacks are leading that game 5-0 in the top of the second inning. The Giants and Dodgers, as we saw at the top of the telecast, both four games back of Arizona. A changeup. Back in center is Goodwin. Way back there. All the way back to the wall, and he can't get to it. Two runs are in, and Houston is going to go for three and make it. So Tyler Houston, on the sixth changeup that he saw, hits a triple off the center field wall.
And the mistake is just too much strike zone. You don't have to use it, not when you have an open base. And he comes very close to putting one out of here. We've seen this the last couple of weeks. The winds here are blowing out to straightaway center field. That's where the carry is to the yard. And routine fly balls are going out with great carry, and they're fooling center fielders. And there's the reaction from Russell.
Beltre, and a fastball in there for a strike. So Tyler Houston pays immediate dividends to his new ball club. His third triple of the year, his 34th and 35th runs batted in. Now Beltre, 236 average, 11 home runs. That curveball into center field, and it's a three-run inning. In the dugout for the Giants. Barry's been doing work with the training staff before games. And the changeup has popped up. Aurelia goes out. Martinez in. Martinez calls him off. The shortstop got called off by the backup shortstop on the same play. 3-0 Dodgers. Ships in the bay at twilight time in San Francisco. And the South Beach Marina, the Larkspur Ferry, tied up alongside, just outside the ballpark. Another beautiful day here in the city of San Francisco. But right now, a crisis at Pacific Bell Park. The Giants are trailing the Dodgers, and they're without most of their best hitters right now. Dusty Baker sending out the best lineup available. Let's take a look at the Giants' batting order, brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Goodwin, the former Dodger, in center field. Ramon Martinez, left field. Jeff Kett, second base. Damon Minor, first base. Homered here yesterday. Aurelia at short. David Bell at third. Tony Torcato in his major league debut, hitting .291 for Fresno. 11 homers, 55 driven in. Yorvik Torrealba, the catcher, and then Russ Ortiz, the pitcher, is batting ninth. Hideo Nomo. And it just doesn't seem, most of the time over the years, to matter to Nomo what lineup they send out there. He beats the Giants. He's beaten the Giants more often than he's beaten any other team. And that is a called strike on the outside. A pitcher's call right there. 3-2 to Goodwin. Hitting .246. Right through the hole, base hit. So Goodwin throw a lot of pitches, then gets the hit.
Can't ask for a better start. A 7-pitch AB, and he's going to challenge with a fastball. You can't walk that leadoff hitter. Fastball down and in, away from Laduca's target. Hey, happy birthday, Tom. All right.
And that has Goodwin heading home, and he'll score as Beltre throws out Martinez. It is 3-1, L.A. That's a Tom Goodwin home run.
That's what speed can do for you. And Tom Goodwin is a smart player to know how to take advantage of that speed. Just a not even a good ground ball gets him scored. Just a topped two-hopper. Beltre realizes it's not worth it with a three-run lead. Gets the sure out, and they concede a run. Manufactured by Goodwin.
So Goodwin continues to make life tough for the Dodgers. Now, here's Jeff Kent. 335 average, 16 homers, 59 driven in. And he curves him for a called strike.
It's a big, slow, slurvy breaking ball that he'll steal a strike with. He's not really going to strike anybody out with it. He very seldom throws it in the strike zone after a first pitch.
Strike the count to Kent. On the right field line, foul. Back into the seats. Kent, only 5 hits in 32 lifetime at-bats against Nomo. 0-2 the count. Kent, since coming back from his leg injury, has not had the same hot bat that he had before. One out, nobody on. Minor on deck. A ball and two strikes now to Kent. 3-1. The Dodgers out front. We're in the last of the first inning. Hideo Nomo facing the Giants. Tom Goodwin got a base hit. Stole second. Went to third on a wild throw. Scored on a 55-foot ground ball.
Easily.
I mean, the Giants haven't done anything to Nomo yet, and yet Goodwin stole a run. He got a Maury Wills type run. That one is hit on way back into left center and out of here by Plenty. Halfway up in the bleachers. It's a one-run game. So we had the Goodwin homer. And now the Kent homer, the more conventional kind.
Wow. That lit this place up.
Now Minor, who hit one yesterday. And he starts him with a splitter for ball one.
Challenge fastball comes right across the plate with it. And Kent gets every bit of it. Oh, that's up there.
More than halfway up, I think.
This one goes up where we haven't seen many hit. About the halfway point, up in left center.
Kent, 17 homers, 60 runs batted in. I mean, Kent is hitting the way he hit in his MVP season 2 years ago.
Yeah, he's dialed. That's a focused dude right there. You won't see him smile till after the game. And that's only if the Giants win.
Now, a guy they'd like to get going in the same way is Rich Aurelia, who stands in now. And you know he's due for a hot streak. Got the call on that one. Strike one to Aurelia.
Torcato talking to Kent about how to approach Nomo. That little hitch when he unwinds and comes at you, you have to have a little pause before you launch at him. Those little triggers that you use, you might start your motion when he comes and drops his backhand. I mean, there's a lot of different ways you might suggest a guy to key on before he starts his move into planting in that front foot and getting his hands up to start a swing.
One and one to Rich Aurelia. He's had 5 hits and 16 at-bats against Nomo. He's 3-for-6 this year against Nomo. Minor at first, the possible tying run. One out. He tries that curveball, misses very high with it. 2-1 the count. Start here, the Giants and Dodgers. Dodgers get 3 in the first. The Giants have come back with 2 so far. That is a splitter to third. Knocked down. The recovery by Beltre, and he still gets him. And Aurelia got a hit.
Looks like he may have caught a piece of Tyler Houston as he was crossing the bag.
Barney Nugent, one of the Giants trainers, who works with Stan Cotty, the head trainer. He's going to go over and see if Aurelia is okay here. Joe LaFay, the coach, is with Rich. Dusty Baker also is going to go over.
Well, Rich wears contact lenses. Trying to leg it out here. Knows the bobble, and the mitt just comes back and slaps him right upside the mug. Comes right back into the line, which Aurelia was running. Remember, that's got a ball in there, too. Ow! So, insult to injury. You make it out, and you get slapped upside the head.
Now, with that contact in there, I mean, it can make you worry when you get a blow to in that area with the contact already in the eye. Could cause some problems with that eye.
Yeah, that's no fun.
Aurelia trying to put everything back together. Fastball up and away. 1-2. David Bell hitting 250. 15 homers, 50 driven in. I mean, the Giants' backup shortstop, the number one option as a backup shortstop is right now the left fielder. And the left fielder, in addition to being the backup shortstop, is also the backup catcher. The splitter. Did he swing? Yes. First base umpire, Carlson. And I think that's wrong. The home plate umpire has to make that call right away if the guy has an option to run. Jeff Kent goes bye-bye, baby. The Giants get 2 back. Two and two. He chases it again. Torcato out of the Death Valley, and they're all going to run. Green, Jordan, and Houston, and a triple for Beltre. It is 7-2. Trey has driven in 4 in this game.
High fastball. He chased the one prior. He comes back again. He doesn't quite get it high enough. And Beltre sent him over the head of Torcato, who's out there trying to figure out right field for the first time. And that's going to get Jay Witasic down and throwing in the Giants bullpen.
Torcato's the first time he's ever played right field for the Giants. The Fresno Grizzlies played some games here early in the season as the finishing touches were being put in their new ballpark, but Torcato is not the right fielder. Here's Grudzielanek, runner at third. It is 7-2 Dodgers. Up the middle. It is 8-2 Dodgers. Ortiz has thrown 57 pitches in these first two innings. And this is one of the worst beginnings to a ball game in Ortiz's career. 8 runs on the board in an inning and 2/3. He's Torres, the 9th hitter of the inning. Angelotic at first. Kent with a dive. Recovers and gets him. But the Giants have a lot of coming back to do, down 8-2.
All right, tomorrow is SBC Pacific Bell Nortel Network's Children's Book Drive. As part of the summer reading program, the Giants will host this year's Children's Book Drive. And the first 10,000 fans that donate a children's book or makes a $5 donation will receive a Lucille pen. There's a vast need for children's books in the Bay Area, and many kids have never owned their own book. So make sure, if you are attending the Giants-Dodgers game 105, to bring your children's book and make a donation. It will help those kids in the Bay Area learn to read, all courtesy of SBC Pacific Bell Nortel Networks. And there is one of the all-time Giants greats.
Bobby Thompson here. The Giants will be honoring their 1951 championship team on Sunday. Bobby Thompson is one of many players from that team who are here for the festivities as Tony Torcato makes his major league debut. Torcato, a left-handed hitter. Bobby Thompson here to see him. And there's that splitter, 0-2 the count. Torcato was hitting .291 with 11 homers, 18 doubles, 55 runs batted in for the Fresno Grizzlies. That one is down the right field line, and he has hit an Nomo splitter for his first major league hit in his first major league at bat.
That's great. You know, he looks right through a fastball. He wants to get... Want to get set to the at-bat, swings through a split-finger fastball, looks bad on the pitch. Then in an 0-2 hole, Nomo comes at him again with a split. He leaves it up just a little bit. And the kid takes advantage of the mistake. Just a little two-strike. That's a great hack, man. I mean, he really, despite the off-speed pitch, keeps those hands back, and there's the result. And Doug McMillan, wherever you're at, you've got to be happy watching that.
22-year-old Tony Torcato by Torre Alba. And he helps Nomo out there, 0-1 the count. Torre Alba hitting .282, 2 homers, 10 batted in. Giants without Benito Santiago, who's got the sty in his left eye. Yesterday, it was just his left eye was closed shut. It's a little better today, but still not available. One and a double play. Bobby Thompson in attendance tonight. It was October the 3rd, 1951. The Giants in the last of the ninth were down 4-2. The winner going to the World Series. Here's what happened.
Hitting at .292. He's had a single and a double, and he drove in the Giants' first run with a long fly to center. Brooklyn leads at 4-2. One out, last of the ninth, back of throws. There's a long play!
And they were going crazy as Russell Ortiz, having taken the ball, takes a strike there. One ball and one strike. Bobby Thompson against Ralph Branca. He didn't hit it all that well. It was only 279 feet to the left field foul pole. Ortiz takes the ball, and it is 2-1. But at the Polo Grounds, he hit it well enough. And it was a 3-run homer. The Giants, who had gone into that ninth inning trailing 4-1, got the 4 runs to win the game. Branca had come in from the bullpen just to face Bobby Thompson. Fan makes the catch in the second deck on that ball. But the larger picture was the Giants had been trailing by 13 and a half games behind the Dodgers with only 44 games left in the schedule. And that completed the greatest comeback that has ever been seen in the game right up to this day. I mean, they're the Yankees were further behind at one point in 1978, but not with only 6.5 weeks remaining in the schedule.
Being 2 weeks back with 6.5 weeks to go. Amazing.
Giants went 37-7. That splitters in the dirt, 3-2 to Ortiz. They went 37-7 to tie the Dodgers and get into that best-of-three playoff. They split the first two games, and then in that final game, Sal Magley against Don Newcomb. Looked like the Dodgers were going to win it anyway until Bobby Thompson got the shot heard around the world, culminating in the miracle of Coogan's Bluff. The Polo Ground, the Giants ballpark, is right at the foot of a hillside called Coogan's Bluff, just across the river from Yankee Stadium. And the next day, they began the 1951 World Series against the Yankees, against all odds. So Ortiz gets a walk, and the batter is Tom Goodwin, who singled his first time, stole a base, stole a run. That's a strike, 0-1. So on Sunday, many of the players who are here will be available, and they'll be part of a big tribute. Alvin Dark was the shortstop on that team, later a Giants manager. He's here. And shortstop is Torres, and the second base, Grudzielanek covering for the force out on Ortiz, and that ends the inning. Wojtasik's been throwing. Let's see if he comes in. Judon, nobody on. But, you know, I mean, this year, home runs are down. Offense in general is down. Now, 1974, 28 years ago, this is Loduca, fastball, called a ball. There were 11 20-game winners, 1974. Right now, there are 12 pitchers who are on pace to win 20 in the major leagues. There have not been as many as 11 20-game winners in a season since 1974. Last year, there were seven. That was the most since 1980, the most in 21 years. Curt Schilling, of course, leads all the pitchers with 17 wins. Torcato going back. So the Dodgers are going after Torcato out there in the outfield. Torcato, who was signed as an infielder by the Giants originally in 1998.
High fastball. Oduka has gone to right field twice now for two doubles. I'm sure they're going to rule this a hit. It would have been a nice play over the hand backhander from Torcato. But when Oduka goes to right field, that's when he hits his best. I mean, he really drives the ball that way. That's his strength.
Right off the heel of the glove, here is Sean Green. Jeff Kent. And that's the inning. And it was scored as a double for Loduca. No runs for the Dodgers. Martinez, Kent, and Minor coming up. Jeff Kent hit a long home run his first time to left center. Sean Green going after this one. So two men gone very quickly for the Giants here in the third inning. Meanwhile, for the Giants, the news is no better out of Phoenix, where Randy Johnson and the Diamondbacks have a huge lead in the top of the sixth inning. It is 9-0 down there. Tony Torcato got a base hit his first time in the major leagues. 22-year-old, former number one draft choice of the Giants. Here is Damon Minor. Fastball up and away. Reggie Sanders, the Giants' usual right fielder, after Torcato had that tough time with that fly ball, and Sanders talked to the rookie.
Talking about taking a route to a ball.
2-0. I mean, it's Sanders. There aren't many that play the outfield that are better than Sanders. Came right in here in a tough outfield, and he played it from the first day like he'd been playing it his whole life. 2-0. 3-0.
Well, sometimes you can't really appreciate a defensive player until he's gone. And he's not out there. I mean, the Giants' outfield is exceptional to what they can do and what they've done all year long, of course, when they're healthy.
to have seen Beltre's triple in the second that really broke this game open. It was 4-2 and he hit it. I'd like to have seen what would have happened with the same ball had Sanders been out there. I mean, that's exactly what you're talking about. I mean, sometimes Sanders, Shinjo, those guys that make it look so easy, Barry Bonds, that it's easy to forget just how many runs they save. 3-2 to Minor. And a splitter. Dwight Kuiper's coming over from the radio booth to join Mike Krukow. On to the fourth inning. It is 8-2 Dodgers.
All right, here at Pac Bell Park, so far it's all Dodgers. It's an 8-2 Dodger lead. And Mike, you know, this is how you do it, right? You forget about the score, and you just deal with Tony Torcato.
Well, yeah, it's becoming the Tony Torcato story. Can I use your microphone?
Can you? It's Krook and Kipe sharing the same microphone. And there's Tony Torcato. Nomo on the ground, softly to Kent, and that will end the inning. A run on three hits for the Dodgers. Giants coming up. It's 9-2 L.A. Aurelia hammers one to center field. Roberts on the move. He's not going to get it. It is off the wall. And Aurelia's got a two-bagger.
So the goal right now for the Giants, put a smile on Dusty Baker's face.
Right.
And this is the start. A mistake location-wise above the belt. And Aurelia going dead center off the wall about a third of the way up. And an easy double. And that's how it starts.
David Bell struck out in the first. He's got a base hit to right field. Aurelia will be held as Green juggles it. Aurelia now decides to go, and he's going to make it. So with Sean Green in the juggle, Aurelia scored. And it's 9-3. Make a dent.
Yeah, Sonny Jackson had the brake light on the whole way. Sean Green, a very sure-handed outfielder with the bobble right here, and as Aurelia went to third base, he saw the bobble. And he decided to challenge the arm. Now, it's great if he scores. But had he not been able to score, it would have been absolutely punch-in-the-stomach disaster.
Laduca couldn't hang on, and here's Torcato. Torcato takes the pitch away. One ball and no strike.
Tyler Houston talking about, remember, Houston's trailing the runner. He's the first baseman talking about when he slapped him in the face his last at bat. Sorry, dude.
Torcato. Career lifetime batting average, 1,000. There aren't many that can say that.
12 for 24, four home runs. He's on fire right now. PCL Player of the Week.
Down the line, foul. 89 mile an hour fastball.
I mean, the kid can hit. It's great when you're talking to Joe LaFay, the Giants first base coach. Joe LaFay studies hitting like pre-med students study anatomy.
Well, what'd you tell me about his swing?
It really reminded me a lot of the swing of Will Clark. He's got a great hand action. It just fires, really releases nicely through the ball.
2-1 pitch. Swing and a miss. 2-2.
This was Torcato's first big league at bat and his first big league knock. Got out there, hand stayed back. Joe LaFay swears by this kid. In fact, I've never seen Joe LaFay give such an endorsement.
2-2. Tony Torcato.
At the Woodland High School, 6'195 pounder, lean.
And he does chase the split by Nomo, so you figured that Nomo was take advantage of that pitch with two strikes on Torcato. And that's one out.
Well, it's a 2-2 count. He's got a chance to go at him in the dirt one time. Nomo really will do that all the time. He's got such a big break in that split. And he got the kid to fish.
Now, for Torcato, it's just a pitch that he needs to see more. That's all.
Yeah, the education is costly here at this level.
David Bell with a short lead. Out of play down the right field line. And that evens the count at a ball and a strike. Well, we've talked about it before where you see young players, they certainly do bring enthusiasm. They also bring mistakes. Here's the 1-1 to Torcato, and it's in the dirt. But I'll say this about Tony Torcato. Whatever questions he had about right field, he'll know a lot about right field by the end of this game. He's been running all over the place.
Yeah, he has. And again, education isn't only in the batter's box. He's getting all kinds of help. It doesn't make a difference. You got to figure it out yourself.
2-1 pitch. High and deep to left. But on the track is Jordan, and he makes the catch. All right, let's check out our American League scoreboard brought to you by Chevron. Baltimore beats Boston at Fenway Park. Detroit a winner in Cleveland. New York over Tampa Bay, but Tampa Bay gave them a battle. The White Sox beat Kansas City at home. Minnesota a winner over Toronto. And Texas scored 9 runs. I think it was in the 7th inning to beat the A's. And Anaheim is shutting out Seattle 7-0 in the 9th.
Anaheim playing great baseball. If they win that ball game tonight, they would be just 1.5 game back of the Seattle Mariners.
Here's Torcato, a single and a strikeout. And a pop-up down the left field line that'll be out of play. Takes a strike at the knees, and it's nothing in 2. Torcato takes a pitch in the dirt. 1-2. The 1-2 pitch to Torcato, and Torcato takes outside. 2-2.
I want to clarify something I said in regards to the standings in the American League West. Anaheim came into this ball game today a game back of Seattle, but 2 games back in the win column, tied in the loss column.
Torcato pops it up. Behind second base, it's Isturiz who makes the play, and there's 1 down.
So if Anaheim would win this ball game, they would be in a tie, separated only by percentage points, having Seattle Mariners having played 2 more games than Anaheim. But point being is that they're playing great baseball, and they've essentially caught the Seattle Mariners. 11-5 Dodgers as we head to the bottom half of the 7th inning. Time now for our Lincoln Drive of the game, and we think Tony Torcato steps up first at bat first big league knock. And your first big league knock means that you have a batting average and you are a big leaguer. So congratulations to Tony Torcato for his first big league hit. And that is our Lincoln drive of the game.
There's a pause drive. They gave me this big vat of popcorn, this big glass case of popcorn, and all the little popcorn cups and whatnot. You had to give a ticket. They gave you a book of tickets. When you took a load out, you had to get the ticket. And what I didn't realize was at the end of the day, you had to pay for all the missing tickets. Here's Green making the grab. Bell is retired. Bell 1-for-4. Well, I didn't sell my first load until the middle of the fourth quarter, at which point I ran down and turned in another ticket and got a whole new load. You know, I was so excited. I mean, it was 88 degrees at the Coliseum that day. Nobody wanted popcorn. I get called two sections over. Hey, you, come here. I go running down, you know, think, oh, all right, a sale. And they said, you got any beer in there? You know, and I had a glass case full of popcorn. So, at the end of the day, there's all these beer vendors and whatnot, you know, soda vendors, counting out their hundreds. And my buddy Ron Cardenas looks at me and says, how'd you do? I says, I'm down $7 for the day. The worst vendor in history. Now to the ninth inning, 11-5, L.A. 11-6, L.A. A high pop-up. Kincaid in foul ground. And it is over. Gagne with 22 pitches. Getting some work in, and the Dodgers wrap up an 11-6 win over the Giants to take the first game of this series. Continuing on tomorrow and Sunday. Tomorrow, Levon Hernandez against Omar Dahl to try and get the Giants even. Thanks for tuning in. John Miller for Mike Kruko and Dwayne Kuiper. Good night from Pacific Bell Park.